Good morning everybody, welcome to my channel. It's Eva from Bohemian Crafting and today I'm coming to share with you new product I've got here on my table. I'm making embellishments from my herbal journal and I wanted to have there something in vintage style. So I have designed for myself these circles with numbers, because I do love numbers, and I forgot to put there, you know, that shade of vintage look. I did cut it out and I glued. I'm gonna show you. I did cut out those circles, and here I've got one from book page, and I'm gonna give it right. Then I cut exactly same size of circles from one dark cardstock and from white cardstock. What I'm doing here is I'm just gluing the designed circle on one side like this, and clear white circle on that opposite side, so it makes nice and strong embellishment. And then I'm punching just hole for jump ring to hang it to my journal. Just like this, it's nice and strong. So I'm gonna make one with this book page because I wanna show you something. And I was wondering if I will use distress inks and distress it, but I wanted to have there that look of vintage, you know, that tea dyed or coffee dyed look. But I know if I will put this to coffee or tea, that color will like vanish and make those shades. And it will be terrible because I did print it out on an inkjet printer. Patricia Viramontes sent me this jar with her own ingredients, some mix of stain. And first I was thinking, will I use it? How I will use it? And when I started to do those small embellishments from actually white paper, I was thinking, oh, that maybe will be that. That maybe will be the thing I will need for my small embellishments, which I'm making from kind of white paper or paper which was printed on inkjet printer, because this amazing substance, I'm not sure what is inside, but this amazing substance doesn't make any changes on your print. It doesn't vanish that print, it doesn't make anything. And here you can see when you put a kind of big layer. So what I did, yeah, and then once I had glued all this, I just used my crocodile first for myself to make sure I will know where I want it. I draw, you know, somehow where I think I will like the hole. I think here I used my crocodile and pointed with that 3/16 of inch. I punched the hole in that circle. That was it. All what I made here, like this. And as I said, if I will put it to coffee or tea, those colors will vanish. I will have their shades of green and red and any kind of shades which I don't like, because it's printed on inkjet printer. So I tried this, and by the way, I used this brush on those circles yesterday, and then I just wiped it to that, you know, that tissue, this antibacterial multi-surface wipes, those wet wipes, and it's nice. It doesn't get glued those brush hairs. So what I did, I just put the layer of this substance on my tags, on those that before you saw, I put quite a large layer. And what I like on this substance, I'm not sure what is inside, but what I like on this substance, I'm gonna move it a little bit, and it needs few seconds, and you will see what the substance makes it itself. It's like grouping. Yeah, I think a layer like this I put on those tags before. I'm gonna wipe it a little bit to try it, to make it just like soft, soft tea dyeing, coffee dyeing. I hope you will see that in the few seconds what this substance makes. It makes like groups of spots or splashes itself. It's like grouping to small layers, which is totally amazing. And it makes that tea dyed, coffee dyed look. And I really love that. And you don't need too much, which is really wonderful. This jar will be for a very, very long time. And I can use it on my inkjet prints, which if you ever try that, those colors are not stable. If you want to coffee dye them, tea dye them, and as you can see, this substance doesn't move anything from that print, which will be moving already if I will use any, you know, watercolored, like water-based colors. It will get wet, that print, and those colors will like vanish to that paper. They will make that disaster on my text. So I'm using this wonderful new product here. I'm gonna just light it here. Hopefully you will see that already. It's like grouping. I'm not sure if you see that. It's like make yeah, this maybe will be better to see. It's like grouping. If you will let it dry itself, that substance will make like spots here and there all around, and it will make beautiful, beautiful coffee dyed, tea dyed look. I want to see how it will look, that book page. So here I can show you. Here you can see how beautiful spots it made. And I've got somewhere one more. Where is that other one? Here. And I put quite a big layer of that substance. So if you will put there just a small layer, here it started already made. Makes those kind of groups. Can you see that? How it moved itself. So it's a wonderful substance. First I was like, will I use it? If I can, you know, my pages, big pages, I can coffee dye, tea dye. So I will probably don't use it for big pages, but for small embellishments, from white book pages, for white printing, this substance is totally amazing. And I love that that it doesn't move my colors. Here I made kind of many brush strokes, so I'm gonna wipe it one more time. So this is stains. I'm gonna close the jar and show you. I will also put link to Patricia Veramontes. This is Stains by Patty Pockets. I will put link for Patricia YouTube channel down below, and I will also have a look. I think I saw that on her Etsy, so I will have a look to her Etsy. I believe she does this jar on her Etsy. So if you are interested to have something for small embellishments, for pockets, for, you know, that additional, what do you make from white book pages, white paper, and you want to have it in a vintage style, but you don't want to make, you know, coffee dyeing, tea dyeing, because it can be a long process and maybe you don't like it. So this one, it's wonderful. It doesn't have any smell. It's wonderful. It's not sticky like sometimes those substances are. It's making those spots. Oh, I like them. Look, especially this one. And I didn't put there too much. Especially this one. And it will be everything. It will be tea dyed, coffee dyed. It will get a little bit darker. But as you can see, it made itself those spots those like groups of this substance, and it will be wonderful. So this is my short sharing for today, Stains by Petit Pocket. I highly recommend this one for small embellishment. So this is my sharing. I hope you all are well. I hope you are taking care about yourself. Thank you so much for visiting me today. Have a wonderful day and see you next time. Bye.